Good afternoon and welcome to Colored Balloons, Poets, and Writers Cafe. I'd like to read to you today a short fiction entitled, Bubbles Don't Last Forever. This is taken from my book, Colored Balloons. I walked in the house to the deafening sound of Beyoncé's Single Lady CD. The bedroom was lit with the aroma of intoxicating Bath & Body Works. The bathroom was cluttered with flat irons, cover girl makeup, and sexy black Victoria's Secret lingerie hung on the doorknob. My twin bed was covered with all of my favorite clothes, and my new designer dress was tossed on her bed. She was forever squeezing her big butt into my clothes. I loved teasing her 200-pound body. Big girls need love, too. I laughed and pinched her chubby cheek. Shut up, rat. Cell phone ringing. Get my phone, Skinny Minnie. I'm going to take my bubble bath, and I'm out of your way. Who's it going to be tonight, I wonder? Remember, don't tell Mama, pulling my ponytail. She thinks I'm over to a friend's house. I would never snitch, although I didn't like the idea of her going out with complete strangers. How do I look? Giving me the duck lips. How could she ruin my new red dress? Yikes, too much makeup, laughing. Girl, you gonna get arrested. It was hopeless for me to scream at her to take off my dress. Thank God her big butt couldn't wear my shoes. What's his name, Laura? Where did you meet him? No answers. Phone ringing. Get my cell phone. Tell him I'm leaving out now. I scribbled the phone number down on my math notebook, a weekly routine. Yelling into the phone, she's coming. Another weird creep, I thought. Locking the door behind her, I climbed into bed early, totally exhausted. Why can't I sleep? She's usually home by 12 midnight, and now it's 2 o'clock in the morning. Calling her cell phone, no answer. Maybe I should call Mama. What if I convince myself not to worry? She'll be back soon. She always comes back smelling of vodka and bad sex and rubbing on my big belly. Hey, little baby girl, I'm here for you. Auntie loves you. Baby girl, please stop kicking. I'm trying to fall asleep. It was 8 o'clock. Mama standing over me. Minnie, where's Laura? She has a hair appointment this morning. No more lies. I covered my head with my pillow and escaped into the darkness, cursing the morning sun. Baby still kicking. Her friend says she hadn't seen her, voice trembling. Look at me. I couldn't face Mama. She was forever praising her good little girls. I'm calling the police. Get up now. I climbed out of bed, holding onto the notebook. Baby kicking. Laura's big, beautiful voice lingered in my ears. See you later, Skinny Minnie. Remember, God loves you. Police ringing the doorbell, haunting silence. Oh, God, why Laura? My baby stopped kicking, water broke, and the unexpected sunlight illuminated the room. For all flesh is as grass, and the glory of man as the flower of grass. But the grass withereth, and the flower thereof falleth away. But the word of the Lord endureth forever. And this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you. 1 Peter, 1st chapter, 24th to the 25th verse, taken from the New James Version. May God add a blessing to the reading of his words. Thank you for coming, and have a very blessed day.